good point. You better ask the man. Why did that train go against the red line?
Where do you want me to wait?
Take the picture, yeah?
Yeah, you're all right. You can come through now. And then I'll clear these points and then... Yeah, you can keep on coming. Once it's been triggered, it goes through two of the points. So there's a few relays flying around, and there's one or two. It's all done on relays rather than transistors. Well, the circuitry that controls the aspects, that's all on one thing.
Is that port engine?
Yes, Heath Coat Electronics. And then Flexile relays. So when the points flow, they trigger the relays and then switch the plug. So effectively, they just sort of switch whatever's coming out of the heat coat box to the appropriate signal.
So you get that halfway to get
it. Yeah. We're allowing the drivers to watch the signals.
What are you saying?
No, we've got no problem with this one.
I'm going to go to the next one. think that's the same thing to me, right?
Thank you.
down, put it up, so
it didn't work, it wasn't in the way of everything else. The only snag is it wastes the siding. I can't leave anything in there because it's constantly in and out to the lift.
Right.
It would have been better off on the edge of the morning. If the railway had really existed, the nearest town would have been Sembrough, up on the edge of the Lake District.
Right.
Just invented an extra valley and stuck the railway in the room until it went around three worlds of a bedroom. And then we moved house. I've currently got two versions of it that are actually operational and two are under construction. Oh no, sorry, three versions operation, two in the club lane.
Amazing.
Right, when I'm going to take that off the
cushion. They're never complete.
Oh no.
There you go.
Tractor that was sitting there and die, and you're being posed for the camera and you're standing and grinning. This occasionally won't do left hand curves. It's a 1970s Agabon steam rail car chassis.
Blimey.
And they have pickups and there's some peculiar metal that doesn't conduct electricity all the time.
Right.
And you go in a straight line and it works.
Yeah.
As soon as you hit a bend, the front axle runs off slightly. If I get hold of it for a moment and just move it side to side a couple of times. As far as that work goes, it's about a 1971 chassis. So it doesn't do it bad.
Siding has a reverse curve. What's the significance of that?
I don't know quite what this addicted
is. What is a perverse curve?
Basically, it's where you can... It's curving away from the fascia, basically. It's an aesthetic thing.
All right, okay.
Not anything else. It's not a technical term.
It's not part of the railway.
No.
Okay, fair.
You used to have reversing triangles.
Yeah, yeah. We get why you have
it. It's more the aesthetics of it, when it's actually based on the curve this way round rather than facing you.
Right, okay.
Travelled a bit.
Just a way, yes. It's not the getting here, it's the getting back we're worried about.
Yeah, it's
like to be a bit more of this going your way than we've got.
The rain has washed away. It should be turned into rain on top of something. So hopefully it'll wash it away before we get there.
Yeah.
There's two chaps in the hub. The other hall are full.
Right. Well, good for them. They're brave to come down. Use the deep.
I think it's BRM that it's not in, even though the other details.
Again.
Yeah.
I'm usually up there that weekend.
You're the third beat person this weekend has mentioned it.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
You can get visitors in from far and wide, then yeah, that's brilliant.
We must be doing something right.
you've got a fair old journey. Thank you.